Hello everyone, welcome to Vidyalakshmi YouTube channel. Myself Moses, chemistry teacher here. Today we are going to discuss few previous NEET questions on IUPAC nomenclature of organic compounds, right? Let us see what are those questions, okay? Let us see the first question here. The IUPAC name of the compound, okay? This is the compound has been given, okay? We have a main chain here of 6 carbons. Let us take 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. We have two functional groups. So here, one is aldehyde, second one is ketone. Aldehyde gets more priority. Ketone gets what we call ketone becomes what secondary grade functional groups here. And we have a what is this substituent? That is methyl group is there, right? Now we have a keto group. This is keto group at third position, and we have a methyl group. This is methyl group at second position. Altogether 6 carbons are there. At fourth position, double bond starts, right? If double bond is there, then it ends with what? Ene. And functional group aldehyde, right? The suffix for aldehyde is al. So ends with ene al, al, not ol over here, okay? At which position the 3 keto is starting over there? It is 5 formyl, it is run. 5 methyl is also run. 3 keto is there in option C and D over here. And at the second position we have methyl group, at second position we have methyl groups and methyl groups over here. All together we have 6 carbons here. 6 carbon means what? Root word is going to be hex, okay? But at what position double bond is starting over there? It is starting at fourth position, right? It has to end with 4 enol, but not 5 enol, right? That's what the answer is, D. That's why the answer is D. Let us see the next question now. Let us see the next question, okay? The structure of the following compound whose IUPAC name is 3-ethyl, once again, 3-ethyl, 2-hydroxy, 4-methyl, hex-3-ene, okay? Now, let us take this one, 3-ethyl, 2-hydroxy, 3-methyl, hex-3-ene, 5-ene, OEC acid, okay? Now, here, till here these three are substituents. Before the root word whatever we have, they are all substituents, okay? And remaining whatever parts comes, they will be included in the root main chain itself, okay? What do we have? At third position we have double bond in. At fifth position what do we have? In means triple bond, which like in the main chain the in double bonds and triple bonds will be included only, okay? Altogether how many carbons are there here? Hex, right? In the main chain 6 carbons are there. Let us see in which we can find the like 6 carbons, okay? Here we have different functional groups. One is carboxylic acid is there, and hydroxy group is there, alkalic functional group is there, okay? Here the main priority goes to carboxylic acid group. That's what numbering starts from carboxylic acid, okay? And it has to go and include double bonds and triple bond. If you go like this, only double bonds are coming. If you go like this, only triple bond is coming, right? By seeing this ene and ein in the main chain itself, right? By that we can decide which molecule is going to be, right? If you take any one of these ways, right? Only we'll include only double bonds or triple bonds in this case and this case. But if you check the last case, right? Here in this like main chain, we can include double bond and triple bond. That's what it is. 3-ene and 5-ene, right? Numbering starts from carboxylic acid here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6, right? Now, what are the substituents are there? In this one, right, we have hydroxy group here which starts with H, we have methyl group which starts with M, we have ethyl group which starts with E, right? When substituents are there more than one, right, then we have to consider their alphabetical order, right? We have E, M and H, which starts initially over there. E starts with, that's what, at third position we have ethyl group, that's what 3-ethyl, at second position we have hydroxy group, 2-hydroxy, at fourth position we have methyl group, 4-methyl, all together we have 6 carbons, right? Means root word is going to be hex. At third position we have double bond, ene. Fifth position what do we have? Triple bond, that's what ene, right? The answer is going to be D. Answer is going to be what? D. Okay. Now let us see the next one. Let us see the next one. Next example. Okay. Which nomenclature is not according to IUPAC system? Which nomenclature is not according to IUPAC system, okay? What is this one? We have to identify a compound which won't obey, okay, IUPAC nomenclature here. Already compounds and names are given, right? Now let us take the first one over here. We have double bond which is starting from the first carbon. We have bromine where it is substituted at the first carbon if you give the priority to bromine, right? When bromine and double bonds are located at the same position, right, from both the sides, which one gets more priority means double bond gets the more priority. When double bond gets more priority, the numbering goes from right to left. 1, 2, 3. Only 3 carbons are there, okay? 3 carbons are there here. 1, 2, 3 carbons are there, okay? Now, bromine gets what position? A third position, right? Bromine should start from 3-bromo. But what is given here? It is given as 1-bromo. That's what the first one is wrong. That's what we have to find, which is not according to IUPAC system. That's what A is the answer, okay? Remaining things, you just check it. You will be getting it. Next. The correct IUPAC name of the following compound, okay? The correct IUPAC name of the following compound. When we give the priority, like the priority order or root word, right? When we include the biggest chain or priority, right? There we have to include the main substituents or functional group, whatever are there, okay? Now, here the functional group is double bond here. Double bond means what? Numbering should start from the double bond. 1, 2, 3. If you go here, right, we will get 6 carbons. 4, 5, 6. Here also, 4, 5, 6, 4, 5, 6, okay. In everywhere, we are getting what? 6 numbers here, 6 carbons here. And which way we have to go? Which way we have to go means, we have to give the numbering in such a way that, in which we can include more number of substituents, right? Now, if you go like this, we'll get 2 substituents over there. One is ethyl group and second one is propyl group. At third position, we have propyl group, and at fourth position we have ethyl group, right? Alphabetically, ethyl starts first. That's what 4 ethyl, 3 propyl, and double bond is starting at the first position only, right? That's what 1-hexene or hex-1-ene, okay? In which case we can find 4 ethyl over there, we have 4 ethyl here, and 3 propyl over there, hex-1-ene, okay? According to the IUPAC nomenclature, right? The first one is the right answer. Next, let us go to the next example. Okay. IUPAC name of the following compound is. Okay. There are some certain terms are there called cis-trans. Okay. Cis means same side, trans means opposite side. Okay. Now, if you take these two, right, these two are hydrocarbons, simple alkyl groups are opposite side, and halogen groups are also opposite, right? Opposite means what? They are trans to one another. Trans means what? We have trans in A and trans in C, but not at B and C, right? We just ignore B and D here. B and D, okay? From which we have to start the numbering? Whenever we start the numbering, right, we have to follow least sum rule, least rule, and all these things are there, right? The substituent, whatever is there, should get the least number. If you start numbering from here, double bond and the substituent get second position. If you start from there, the substituent and the double bond gets third position, right? Third position is like 3 is bigger than that of 2, that's what we have to go numbering from left to right. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. At second position, what do we have? We have chlorine, which starts with C. We have iodine, which starts with I, right? Alphabetically, chlorine comes first, that's what 2 chloro. This is trans, right? Trans, 2 chloro, 3 iodo. At second position, double bond is starting, right? That's what pent-2-ene or 2-pentene we can say. Okay, we have trans, 2-chloro, 3-iodo, 2-pentene is there. Here, trans, 3-iodo has given. According to alphabet, right, I and C is there. C should come here, right? That's what, C is not the option. The only option remaining is A. Let us see the next question, okay? The IUPAC name of the following compound is, okay, we have double bond here and we have triple bond here, okay? Which one gets more priority? When both are located in the identical position from the both the side, right? Then double bond gets the more priority. But according to numbering, here from in the first carbon itself, triple bond is there. But double bond starts from left side, right? At the second position, okay? We have to go numbering from the right to left because the triple bond starts at the first carbon itself. That's what numbering goes, something like this. 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Now, at the third position, ene is there. At first position, ine is there. Alphabetically, E will come first, right? all together 5 carbons are there. 5 carbons root word is pent. Everywhere pent is there, fine. Okay, now ene is there and y is there. Which will come first? Ene will come first, right? At what position? 3 ene should come, right? Where do we have 3 ene? Here we have 3 ene and 1 ene, right? That's what the option is B. The option is B. Next question. Next question. The IUPAC name of the compound having the molecular formula. Here, double bond and triple bond is there. Both are in identical position from the both the side. Okay. We have triple bond starting from the first carbon. Here also from the right side, double bond is starting from the first carbon. Okay. Which one gets some more priority? When double bond and triple bond is there, double bond gets some more priority. That's why numbering starts from right to left. 1, 2, 3 and 4. Right. Now, this is ene starting with E. This is ene starting with Y. Right. Now, altogether 4 carbons are there. Right. 4 carbons are there. 4 carbon means what? Bute is the root word here. Okay. Which one gets some more priority? Ene will get some more priority, right? That's what. Where we can see one ene, we have one butine. One butine means here in this option, the triple bond is getting more priority. This is wrong. Okay. The second option, if you take, okay, bute one ene is there. Again, what is this one? Ene is getting triple bond is getting more priority. Now, this is not the answer. One butene, 3 ene. One butene, double bond is there. 3 ene is there, right? That's what. The answer is this one. Again here, 1 ene means what? Again it is wrong. Again it is wrong. The option is C. Next. Okay. Now let us take this particular example. IUPAC name of the following compound. Okay. What is the functional group here? What is the functional group here? This is acid halide is the functional group. Acid halide is the functional group. The suffix for acid halide is oil halide. Oil halide. Oil halide, okay. Total number of carbons are 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. At second and third position we have methyl group, right? That's what it starts something like 2, 3 dimethyl pent oil, what is this? Pentanoil chloride. Pentanoil chloride. Where it starts 2, 3 dimethyl? Here we have 2, 3 dimethyl pentanoil chloride. Oil chloride is the suffix for the acid chloride functional groups, right? That's what. The answer is C. The answer is C. This is about what we call, let us see the next example here. The UPS name of the following compound, okay. Here we have carboxylic acid functional group, we have amine functional group and we have double bond here, right. Since carboxylic acid gets more priority, that's what numbering starts from here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. Okay, 7 carbons are there. At third position we have amino group, right? That's what it has to start, 3 amino. In which case it is starting 3 amino? In the case of first only it is starting 3 amino. At fifth position what do we have? Double bond, right? That's what, 5 heptene. Ene means double bond here. And the main functional group here is oic acid. Oic acid is nothing but the carboxylic acid. That's what option 1 is the right answer. Next, IUPAC name of the compound, okay. What are those functional groups are there here? We have double bond, we have hydroxy group and we have aldehyde functional group, right? Here aldehyde functional group gets some more priority. That's what starting, numbering starts from aldehyde functional group from right to left over there, 3, 4 and 5. Okay. What are the substituents? We have methyl group is there and hydroxy group is there. Hydroxy group starts with it, H, methyl group starts with M over there. Alphabetically hydroxy group comes first, right? That's what at fourth position hydroxy group is there. That's what it starts, 4 hydroxy. Here in these two cases we have 2 hydroxy. That's what we can simply eliminate these two options, okay. And then what do we have? 4 hydroxy is over, 2 methyl group is there, right? In the case of first one it is 1 methyl and in the case of second one it is 2 methyl group. And all together 5 carbons are there. At second position what do we have? Ene. And aldehyde functional group suffix is Al, okay. That's what the option B is right answer. Option A is wrong, okay. Next, okay. This is about what we call, these are the few previous NEET questions, right. This is how we have to identify and solve the problems over here. In the case of nomenclature, right, there are specific parts of the nomenclature, okay. We have a root word which gives number of carbons. before the root word, prefix will be there. After the root word, suffix will be there. Prefix again classified into primary and secondary. Suffix again classified into primary and secondary, right? The primary prefix which starts first gives information about cyclic compound. If it is cyclic compound, the name starts with cyclo. Okay, secondary prefix gives about gives the information about substituents or secondary grade functional groups. Now only we have discussed, this is the hydroxy group, right? Hydroxy group. Hydroxy group means what here? If only hydroxy group is present, then we will take it as ol. But if it is a secondary grade functional group, we will take the prefix of OH group. Prefix of OH group is nothing but hydroxy, right? That's what in the second, what we call secondary prefix, right? Substituents or secondary grade functional group can be considered. Next root word comes. In the root word, number of carbons can be included. And then next primary suffix will come, in which we can say the degree of saturation, right? If all single bonds are there in the carbon chain, it is going to be N. Double bonds are located, in. Triple bonds are there, ein. Okay, and last one is secondary suffix gives information about the main functional group. Okay, here the main functional group is what? CHO group. The suffix of CHO group is AL. Okay, that is according to this, if we learn, right, all these things, primary prefix, secondary prefix, root word, primary suffix and secondary suffix, right? In this way, if you learn, it is very easy to solve the problem. Okay, thank you for watching. If you like the video, please like, share and subscribe the channel. For more interesting videos, for more updates, right, press the bell icon. Thank you.